Hi, I'm Kotaro Senpuku of Nikken Sekkei. In today's presentation, I'd like to talk about self-folding wrist origami based on all-stick kirigami. Kirigami is a transmodal system written by altering cut or seat material and bending or folding the seat. We investigate the behavior of kirigami with cross-shaped orthogonal cut in the seat material. When a tensile force is applied to a relatively thick seat with this seat pattern, all panels rotate on the same plane and the seat extends in two directions. Microscopically, it behaves an all-stick material. In other words, a material has a negative Poisson's ratio. Kirigami with such property is called all-stick kirigami. In contrast, it is reported that when a tensile force is applied to a thin seat, three-dimensional corrugated surfaces are induced by out-of-plane buckling. The purpose of this research is to apply buckling-induced kirigami to architecture-scale deployable structures. In the previous research, the buckling behavior of kirigami is realized by local material deformation near the connections, and its application was limited to a relatively small scale. In this research, we solved this problem by making an equivalent kirigami system with rigidly foldable origami, which is a mechanism connecting rigid bodies with a rotating hinge. There are two existing CLIST models for the all-stick kirigami pattern. Rafsanjani and Bertoli show models of buckling-induced kirigami with one CLIST line added to each connection as observed at the yield line after the buckling on thin materials. The resulting mechanism has a 1 degree of freedom, but it's no longer all-stick. Tang et al. Proposed a mechanism with three CLIST lines added to each connection. If the structure is constrained in a plane, it behaves as an all-stick kirigami. However, there are excessive out-of-plane degree of freedom, thus the transformation cannot be synchronized. In this research, we propose a mechanism with two CLIST lines to add to each connection. The resulting structure is 1 degree of freedom and all-stick for a certain range of design parameters. First of all, we explain the kinematics of the proposed structure. The structure is composed by transtensional copy of the same module, where the module is a loop of four panels around a single seat. Although each module is a 2 degree of freedom mechanism, the overall mechanism becomes over-constrained. In general, over-constrained structures are not transformable. However, proposed structures become a 1 degree of freedom mechanism due to the point symmetry of 8 creases maintained during the folding transformation. Also, the directions of creases can be expressed by 4 vectors L1 to L4. The four angle constraints between four vectors are equivalent to deployable degree for single vertex wrist origami composed of vectors L1 to L4. Therefore, the folding motion of this kirigami structure is equivalent to the folding motion of the deployable degree for single vertex wrist origami. For more details, please refer to the paper. Next, we analyze the microscopic behavior of the structures using the singular value decomposition. Because the deformation of the structure is uniform, the microscopic deformation gradient tensor F can be given by the deformation of each module. The deformation gradient tensor is obtained as a transformation matrix that transforms vectors A and B to vectors A' and B' respectively. By applying singular value decomposition to the matrix, we obtain two singular values sigma1, sigma2, left singular vectors u1, u2, and right singular vectors v1, v2. The left singular vectors indicate the principal directions of deformation in the folded state, and the right singular vectors indicate the principal direction of the deformation in the initial state. The singular values represent the expansion or shrinkage rate of the kirigami along the left singular vectors. Thus, if sigma I is greater than 1, It indicates that Kirigami is expanding along direction ui. And if sigma I is less than 1, it indicates that Kirigami is shrinking along direction ui. In this analysis, we focus on a flat foldable family of Kirigami modules that are given by parameters alpha and gamma. Alpha is the angle between the two creases added to connections. Gamma is the rotation angle of the connection while maintaining alpha. This figure shows a plot of two singular values when the fold angle is varied from 0 to 180 degrees. Among the endpoints of the curve, point 1,1 represents the initial state, and the other endpoint represents the flat folded state. In conclusion, we found that alpha is only related to singular values, and gamma is only related to directions of the singular vectors. By changing alpha, we can characterize the transformations as expansion into directions, expansion and shrinkage, and shrinkage into directions while it's independent of gamma. The yellow area shows that the range of available transformations for different alpha. In particular, at alpha equals 45 degrees, sigma 1 and sigma 2 are always greater than 1. This shows an austic transformation with expanding in two directions. It could not be obtained by existing buckling-induced Kirigami. At alpha equals 90 degrees, only one crease is folded at each connection, and transformation is accompanied by expansion and shrinkage. At alpha equals 135 degrees, sigma 1 and sigma 2 are always less than 1. This also shows an austic behavior, but it shrinks in two directions like Milford. Next, when sigma 1 is greater than 1, we propose to depress structure by pulling the structure in the first principal direction. This ensures the deployment force is the minimum. We found the singular vectors were characterized only by gamma and independent of alpha. Moreover, we observed the right singular vectors v1 and v2 are constant during the folding motion. Also, when changing gamma by some amount, the singular vectors rotate by the same amount. This structure can be multilayered with its translated copy while maintaining least folding motion. The more tessellation can be joined together to form a consistent 1 degree of freedom mechanism. The same translation operations can be applied multiple times to form a several materials that fill the 3D space. We conjecture that self-folding can be induced by applying tensile force along the singular vector. We verify such self-folding behaviors and the austic behaviors of our structures through experiments. We compare the behaviors for the single-layered and multi-layered structures. The results of the three experiments show that transformation is generally more homogeneous and self-folding is more stable in this multi-layer structure than in the single-layer structure. Next, we fabricated a meter-scale multi-layer structure using a thick panel material. To produce the crystallines, we used a CNC cutting machine to half-cut the material from one side and leave the skin surface of the sandwich panel as a compliant hinge. Because all hinges are laid out on the same side, the Kirigami structure using thick material is consistent with the folding motion of zero-thickness Kirigami. To create a two-layered model, we stacked the structure so that the surfaces with hinges touch each other. This allowed for a consistent mechanism after riveting the two structures at their overlapping regions. Then, by pulling along the direction of the expansion, we were able to make it into the desired 3D shape. Finally, we propose some applications for this structure. This structure is similar to the manifold, so it could be useful for deployable structures, mechanical metamaterials, and lightweight structures such as core materials for the sandwich panels. And this buckling-based formation of 3D shape in Kirigami has a potential advantage in manufacturing because it realized by self-folding. It doesn't require synchronous actuation of creases of the complex patterns required for origami without slits. In addition, this structure may be useful for acoustic devices by utilizing its variable corrugated surfaces, or for control light or wind by utilizing its variable voids. That brings me to the end of my presentation. Thank you for your attention. That brings me to the end of my presentation. Thank you for your attention.